Let's go back to this network structure. If we want to find the partial derivative of the loss function, C to null functions, we first have to do some preparatory works. The first is to set the initial values of the null parameters. We first set them casually, then we need to determine the activation function in these null places. We can also set them at our will, C1 to H1, C2 to H2, C3 to Y. They are all sigmoid. Note that here we are. Note adding a layer of neural structure, they are used as step function from C3 to the final output Y. But here, C3 to Y cannot be a step function because its derivative is zero, except the origin. We have no way to gradient descend it. At this point, input x1 equals 1 and x2 equals 0. Then we can fill in all the blanks. C1 equals x1 times w1 plus x2 times w2 plus b1 equals 0.8. H1 equals sigmoid c1 equals 0.69. C2 equals x1 times w3 plus x2 times w4 plus b2 equals 1.1. H2 equals sigmoid c2 equals 0.75. C3 equals h1 times w5 plus h2 times w6 plus b3 equals 1.69. Y equals sigmoid 0.3 equals 0.84. There is some gap between it and goal 1 entered. We can further calculate the loss C. What we use here is the mean square error loss function. In the case of entering one point, C is like this. But when we bring in the values of uppercase Y and lowercase y, we get 0.0120. This process is called forward propagation. We fill in all the blanks from left to right. Then let's start to talk about back propagation, which from the picture above. By referring to C on the right, we try to figure out what the values of B and W on the left are going to change. How should we calculate exactly? This requires we to gradually descend loss function to find the partial derivative of C to these nine parameters. Take B3 as an example. To calculate the partial derivative of C to B3, we have to use the chain rule to find the derivative of the compound function. That is to find dc divided by dy times dy divided by dz3 multiplied by dz3 divided by db3. Among them, the first term dc divided by dy can be derived from such this formula. In order to deduce it, we need to use the chain rule again. Dc divided by dy equals the outer derivative uppercase y minus lowercase y multiplied by the inner derivative -1, that is -1 times uppercase y minus lowercase y equals minus 0.16. The second term, dy divided by dz3, is the derivative of sigmoid, and the derivative of sigmoid is easy to remember, which is y times 1 minus y, which in this case equals 0.13. z3 equals h1 times w5 plus h2 times w6 plus b3. The variables here are b3, w5, and w6. To find the partial derivative is to take the variables other than b3 as a constant to derive. So dz3 divided by db3 equals 1. When you multiply these three terms, you get that the partial derivative of C for B3 is equal to negative 0.020. Similarly, partial derivative of C to W5 and C to W6 can also be derived in this way. We can calculate the top layer W1, which has a longer partial derivative equation. You need to calculate these five values. We have just calculated the value of the first and the second. DC divided by DY is negative 0.16. DY divided by DD3 is 0.13. There are three items left. According to D3 equals H1 times W5 plus H2 times W6 plus B3, the partial derivative is W5, which is 0.5. In the fourth item, the relationship between H1 and C1 is actually sigmoid. So the derivative is H1 times 1 minus H1 equals 0.69 times 1 minus 0.69 equals 0.21. According to Z1 equals X1 times W1 plus X2 times W2 plus B1, the last term DZ1 divided by DW1 is X1, which is 1. So we can calculate that the partial derivative of C to W1 is equal to negative 0.002. By analogy, we can find the partial derivatives of C2, W1, W2, W3, W4, W5, W6, B1, and B2. In this case, only one data point is entered, but we have to enter the next data point. X1 equals 0, X2 equals 1, Y equals 1. Then we calculate the partial derivatives of 9 variables. After traversing these 4 points, we need to average the 4 partial derivatives of each variable, multiply it by the step size. Then we'll get a value that the variable should change in this iteration. In this way, each iteration can make the results of these 4 examples more accurate. So after several rounds of gradient descent, our neural network can automatically separate these 4 points.